You're listening to Men of Abundance, episode 145. And once again, this is Pay It Forward, Aloha Friday. How are you making connections? And are you making a difference?
Welcome to Men of Abundance, the podcast for those looking to level up their lives by hanging out with some of the greatest leaders and established professionals in our community, living a life of integrity, honor, and the abundance mentality. Prepare to pay it forward with your host, former Army medic turned lifestyle entrepreneur, Wally Carmichael.
Aloha, men of abundance. It is another Pay It Forward Aloha Friday. I am Wally Carmichael, your host and founder of the Men of Abundance podcast, the Pay It Forward community. And I love this conversation because one of my favorite things to do is to make connections. I love meeting new people. And that's just another reason why this podcast is such a perfect fit for me, as well as my up and coming coaching business, which now I have been coerced into. Yeah, you've really twisted my arm. Some folks have contacted me. It's been many months. It's been about 8 months since the first person contacted me and asked me if I coached, if I mentored, if I helped other people, other men, in the ways of living a life of abundance. And I was quite honored when I first heard that. And then another guy asked me, and then a lady contacted me and asked me if I would help her husband live a life of abundance. And then I knew that I absolutely had to figure this thing out. And the fact of the matter is, I had coached men and women in health and fitness and in various aspects of their life, but not on a professional level, mostly on a personal level throughout my military career. I guess you could say it was professional level because part of my job was to lead, coach, and mentor men and women in the United States Army. But I also had led group training and worked one-on-one with people in health and fitness. But I had never coached anybody in living a life of abundance ever since I made the realization that I myself was in fact living and am in fact living a life of abundance. In any case, back to what I was originally talking about, which is making connections. And some of you may know this already. I have slightly mentioned it here and there on the show, but I don't know if any of those shows had aired yet. I think most of the conversations that I had are for on other people's shows or on a show that's not aired yet. So here we go. One thing that I have been doing recently, since many of you do know that I am living split ups right now, I'm living in Hawaii while my family is in Tampa. And part of the reason for that is so that I can put this program together, so that I can put this coaching program together, work on my book, and finish up some projects here in Hawaii, and then I'm going to go meet up with my family. Well, one other thing that I've been doing since I've had more time on my hands was I decided to start driving as a Lyft driver. You've heard of Uber, you may have heard of Lyft, but Lyft is getting very, very popular. And I was getting these emails and I was messing around with the app one day on my phone and I figured, what the heck, let me see if I can register my 2011 Toyota Tacoma long bed four door and see if I can be a Lyft driver. So I did it, and about 3 days later, I receive an email on a Sunday that says, congratulations, you're all set to go, just turn on the app and start driving. So I did. And I drove down the hill from up here in Manoa, and I drove down to Waikiki. And in the first hour or so, I had picked up about four or five people and made like $38. But the cool thing was I had met some amazing people. My very first people that I picked up was two young men who were just traveling the world, basically. They were here in Hawaii. They were working at a bar, and they've only been here for about a month. And what they've been doing is traveling the world, mostly at this point around the United States. Next day, I think they were going to go to Australia or something. And they're just getting little jobs, just enough to feed them and allow them to have a place to stay. And I thought that was just the coolest thing to see two young men doing this. Now, they were partying hard. They were both, one of them was hungover, and I think the other one was still drunk at about noon. They were on their way to work, which was cracking me up. I've met one couple. I met a mother and a daughter who they were both from China, but the mother spoke no English. She was on her way back to China. The daughter was on her way to Atlanta, where she had been working and gone to school and been working, and now she's going back to China to continue working. I have met so many people. Well, here's one cool thing that just happened just this evening. So I gave a couple a ride, and I asked them as they get in, I asked them, you know, well, what do you do? You know, how do you contribute to humanity? Which they usually like that kind of question. So they said, well, we're entertainers. I said, no kidding. So I start talking to them. That really intrigues me about entertainers. So what this couple has been doing is they've been traveling around. They just came from Tennessee. They've been to a lot of other states, and now they're here in Hawaii. And they're traveling around, and they're entertaining people on the streets with a Donald Trump and a Kim Jong-un costume. And I saw them. I saw them this last weekend, Donald Trump and Kim Jong-un, taking pictures in Waikiki with tourists and everybody. And that's who these people were. So the man and the woman, the man, I guess, is Donald Trump. And then Kim Jong-un was already downtown. And they're part of this whole team. And what they're doing is they're traveling around, and then they're donating some of what they earn to different charities. And they're really kind of sending a message along the way as they're doing this. They're not just entertaining people, from what I got from it in our short ride. You got to understand, most of these rides are pretty short, like maybe 10 or 11 minutes. Some of them are a little bit longer, where we have longer conversations. But back to this couple this evening. So here was the really cool thing. They were intrigued because on the back of my seats, in the back seat, I have this little sign, and I'll have the picture of the sign in the show notes so you can see what I'm talking about. And at the top it says, Aloha, I'm Wally. And then it goes on to say, it's my pleasure to serve you. Be abundant in your thoughts. And then I also have on there, and you'll see the rest that's in there. And so that is what really intrigued this couple. They really liked the idea that I said, be abundant in your thoughts. And then in the lower right-hand corner, it says, Men of Abundance, the Pay It Forward community. And they noticed that I donate a portion of my 10% of my earnings to veterans. So we got to talking about donating and all this other kind of stuff. And he started talking about conversations about attracting the right type of people to you and all these other different, you know, very positive conversations. And I told him, I said, well, that Men of Abundance is my podcast, and we have those conversations on a regular basis. So then I said, you really should listen to my latest episode, episode 144, where I had a conversation with a former skinhead. And before I finished what I was saying, the young lady that was sitting right behind me, she said, is his name Christian Picciolini? And I said, yeah, it is. And she said, you got to be kidding me. I was just literally spent hanging out with his son, Devin, like 2 weeks ago. I said, you have got to be kidding me. So I bring this up because, one, it's a very, very small world. I started driving for Lyft October 21st, and since then, I have picked up and given rides to 206 people. And during those conversations, I cannot tell you how many times I've had a conversation with somebody who was either from my same hometown or knew something very similar to what I know, had been to locations I've been in, all that, you know, blah, blah, blah. It's not really that big of a deal. But when you look at the grand scheme of things and the conversations that we had that were so familiar, it was simply amazing. And I'm telling you, I have picked up people from all walks of life. I've picked up transgenders. I've picked up all different races. Now, here in Hawaii, we've got a little bit of everybody, which is another reason why I love living in Hawaii. I've picked up so many people, and I've had amazing conversations with just about every one of them. Some people are kind of quiet. They just sit there on their phone, and they do their thing, and that's cool, and I respect that. But those that want to talk, we have really cool conversations. Well, the other thing that I want to point out here is divine intervention, because any number of Lyfts or Ubers, well, they specifically ordered Lyft, but any number of the Lyft drivers could have picked them up. But it was me. I picked them up. And we had this conversation about living a life of abundance. We had this conversation about giving back to people, about donations and how the more you donate, when you donate, you get it back tenfold. And all this kind of stuff that we talk about here. And then they started, you know, they took pictures because I ran out of business cards. So they took pictures of the placard that I have in the back of the truck. And I'm sure they're probably going to be listening to this. Now, I'm leaving their names out, even though I could use their first names and nobody will really know who they are. But I just don't think it's cool mentioning their names because they didn't give me permission to do so. But of course I mentioned Christian's name because he was just on the show, and his son's name because he mentioned his son and his son's out there in social media with him. But nonetheless, I just think it's cool. Now, here's the thing about the connection part is I was connected to Christian through, as I mentioned in the episode, in episode 144, Christian and I were introduced through Kevin Henry. Now, Kevin Henry is a gentleman who lives here in Hawaii as well. And Kevin and I were introduced because my wife has taken sociology in college, and she needed some place to volunteer her time, and she was looking for a place to do so. And she got connected through another friend of hers who lived down the street from us that we were introduced to her from some high school friends of mine. You see what's happening here? So it all started from some high school friends of mine that I grew up with that introduced my wife and I to a couple that my friends from high school met while they were in Germany. Now they're all here in Hawaii. And my wife got to know the lady that, it's getting confusing, right? My wife got to know the lady that my high school friends introduced us to. She introduced my wife to Kevin. Then Kevin connected with me on Facebook, saw what I was doing with Men of Abundance, listened to a couple of shows. Within a couple weeks, him and I met and had coffee together, had a great conversation. Within a couple weeks after that, he introduced me to Christian. And then Christian and I have this amazing conversation a month or so ago. It posts today. Then I give this couple a ride today who knows Christian personally. They're all the way over in Hawaii. They don't live here. I could have picked them up out of 100 other people that were in the area. Anybody else could have picked them up. So it's all coming back around full circle. What does this mean as far as, you know, any of us getting connected and any of us bettering our lives in any way, shape, or form? Hell, I don't know. Who really knows? All I know is my life has been enhanced by all of these connections. So my question to start the show out with was, who are you connecting with and are you making a difference? Because ultimately, the way we make a difference in this world is through all of our connections. And you can substitute the word connections for relationships. Because sometimes the connections really are not their acquaintances, maybe, or their close friends. And you can go anywhere in between on that. But the connections that you have and the people that you connect others to will always come back around to you. And none of us, not one of us, can do anything without great connections. Let me share just one more story with you. And I'm sorry, but I got to be kind of vague on this particular story because I don't want it to be out broadcasted worldwide just yet. Because this individual who shared this story with me just today only shared it with me, but then I asked him to go ahead and share it in our Men of Abundance community, and he did so. But I still want to keep it kind of vague unless, and the only way you're going to know what I'm talking about is unless you're in the Men of Abundance community. But, and I will use the gentleman's name, and that is Deuce Pesek. Deuce Pesek was one of my earliest guests. And in fact, we had such a long conversation, such an amazing conversation. I had to make it a part one and part two. He's the only part one and part two of the show that we've had so far. And that's episode 26 and 27. You can go listen to that. And for the longest time, episode 26 was the number one most downloaded episode. But now I think it's like number two or maybe number three. I'm not sure just yet. But Deuce Pesek shared something with me that he's got an amazing, amazing invention that he has with these structures that is, you know, designed to go out into remote areas, be easily set up, very stable, very sturdy. And as he says, they were specifically built for somebody like myself, a combat airborne medic who deploys to a very isolated environment or maybe someplace like in a hurricane situation, right? So he's been looking for funding to help him with this project. And he has made connections and connections. He came on my show, got some connections from that. But he's always connecting with somebody and always telling his story and always talking about his products and what he's got going on. Finally, he's possibly gotten connected with a very high influencer and somebody who may be able to help him fund his project. And I'm super, super excited for him. Now, somebody could say, in fact, somebody did say in the group, and he did bring up a good point, is that, you know, by talking about stuff like that can make it kind of cheap. But the fact of the matter is if you talk about stuff like that to the right people and make the right connections, then you can actually get your projects off the ground. Because if you were to be quiet about it, if Deuce Pesek was to be quiet about this project, then he would never have a chance of getting funded. And by Deuce Pesek getting his project off the ground, he is going to positively affect so many lives in multiple ways. So again, my point of this episode is this. Make connections, not just for yourself, but make connections with other people. When you run into somebody and you're having a conversation, don't always look for what's in it for me. Look at it as, I'm listening to this person's story. I'm listening to what their message is. I see they have a need. I know somebody else who I need to connect this individual with. And they're going to be able to collaborate and help each other. And then take yourself out of the equation. By doing that, you're physically taking yourself out of the equation. But in reality, you're all up in that equation. At some point in time, it's going to come back to you. Either one of those two individuals are going to bring it back to you, or God is going to bring it back to you. The universe is going to bring it back to you. I'm telling you, it just happens time and time again. So make these connections, make your own connections. Talk to as many people as you possibly can. I'm telling you right now, I'm having a blast driving for Lyft. Because out of the 206 rides that I've done so far, I've met well over 400 people. Because in most of those rides, there was at least two people. And in some of those rides, I had up to four, even five people in my truck at one time. And we were just at, I picked up, I got to tell you this one real quick. I picked up the USS Nimitz came into town, the aircraft carrier. And all of these Navy and Marines were just flooding all over Waikiki and Honolulu. So I picked up four sailors, and it was two girls and two guys, and they just wanted to hear Christmas music. So I gave them the auxiliary cord to my truck. I have a big jam box, a boom box in my truck behind the seat, and we were just blasting Christmas music all the way down to Waikiki until I got them to their hotel. They were just amazed at, this was their first time in Hawaii. They had just come from India somewhere, and it was just such a hellhole from the way they described it. They said, don't ever go there. And they just loved what they were doing here. They were looking forward to going out and getting a drink, and a couple actually. They were really riled up and ready to go. I had to give a little safety brief before I let them out of the truck. But they were just having a blast, and we were blasting some Christmas music. We just had a great experience together. So I've been able to connect with so many people. And then, of course, doing this podcast, I have met some of the most amazing people in the world, had conversations with them for the show, before the show, and even since the show has aired, we have collaborated. I've connected them with other people. They have connected me with so many other people. I can go through that circle that I went through from my high school buddies all the way through to meeting Christian. I can go through multiple different stories of those connections that I've been through over the last year and a half. And they have enhanced my life in so many ways. So what can you do? Make connections. When you're sitting next to somebody, get off your phone. Take your eyes up. Look at the person in the eye that's next to you or in front of you. Have a conversation with them. Get off of Facebook. Get off of social media. I like it too. I do like connecting with people. And I have connected with quite a few people on social media for the show and met them either over the microphone or even in person. But every day when you're out walking around and you're out doing your daily activities, talk to people face to face. Ask them, what do you do to contribute to humanity? Have a conversation about that and listen to what they're saying. Find out a way that you can serve them and see if you can think of somebody else that you have recently met or have known for a while that you can connect them with so that they can collaborate and create beautiful and amazing things together. It's an awesome feeling just knowing that you played a small little part in that connection and that relationship. Oh, and before I let you go, since I've been driving for Lyft, people have been asking me, what is it like? What's it like driving for Lyft? I explain it like this. It's kind of like playing Pokemon Go with my 8-year-old. Only difference is when a little bling comes up and I see that I got to go pick up a new critter, I can go to the destination. It takes me right to where that person is at. I call them critters because it's fun and it's Pokemon Go and all that stuff. But I pick up the critter. I have an awesome conversation with the critter. And then I go drop them off and they pay me when I'm done, and they leave me 5-star reviews. I got some very high reviews because I got my truck all set up really cool right now. I got Christmas lights in there, and I got mints for them, and I even got a charger for this iPhone. I got a charger for their Android. I got the auxiliary cord if they want to listen to their own music. Man, I got it set up for them. They're just having a blast, and we're having amazing conversations. If you're thinking about being a Lyft driver, do you and I a favor and click on the link that's in the show notes, because you can get some extra bonuses by clicking on that link, and I get some bonuses as well. And just as it says on my placard you're going to see in the show notes, I donate 10% of everything that I earn to a veterans organization. So click on that link in the show notes. And if you have not already downloaded the Lyft app for your phone so you can start using Lyft instead of Uber, then click on the other link that says Lyft Rider, and you will get a $20 credit for Lyft. And again, complete transparency, I get a kickback off of that as well. And again, I do donate 10% of my earnings to veterans. Last month, I already donated $100 to Moe's Heroes. And oh, by the way, the other 90% goes to a veteran as well. That's me. Now, go out and live your life of abundance.